Hi guys, in this tutorial we'll see how to fetch URL parameters in AngularFi. In this tutorial we have an app component which is having a router outlet and which is dynamically populating two components. That is, first one is the send component and the other one is the receive component depending upon the URLs. So here we will see how to call the URL of the receive component from the send component for passing the parameters, and the receive component will see how to fetch the value of that parameter from the URL. So let's see the code. So this is the AngularFi project. We have an app routing module. So here you can see when the path is send, send component is called, and when the path is receive and the parameter name, then the receive component is called. We have this app routing module which is imported in our main app module. So here we are importing our app routing module, our send component and the receive component. And we have also imported the module here and both the components in the declaration. So let's see our send component. It's an empty component having an empty template just with a simple text. And similarly, the receive component, which is also having an empty template. So let's run this. So as you can see, since the URL is send, the send component is called. So now we will call the receive component URL from the send component. So let's go to our send component. Here we'll quickly import the router module, and in the send component class we will create a constructor which will instantiate an instance of the router module. So in the template we'll just quickly write the router link here using an href. So you can see here we have just passed a router link, and the value of that router link is receive and the parameter name which is defined in our router module, that is this. So we are hard coding the parameter value, that is in this case it is 1. And the second method is, let's create a button which will call a function, and in this function we will use the navigate method of the router, and using that method we will just call the URL of the receive component. So let's see that. So let's create the go to next page function. Let's define a variable param id, and I'm hard coding it to 3. And here after this I will just write this dot router dot navigate method, and this is the URL and this is the value of the id parameter, which is 3. So let's run this. So as you can see, we have a link and a button. So this is the link and this is the button. So I will just first click on the link. And as you can see, it has navigated me to the receive component. The URL is receive and the value is 1 for that parameter, which is hard coded. And similar fashion, when I click on the button, it will also take me to the receive component. And this time the value of the ID parameter is 3. So as you can see here, in first case the value is 1, and in the second case when I click the button, the go to next page function is called, and in the go to next page function the navigate method accepts the URL and the value of the parameter. So now we'll see how to fetch the value of the parameter in the receive component. So let's quickly go to the receive component. So in the receive component, we'll quickly import the onInit. We'll also import the activated route, router, and the param map from the Angular router module. So now the activated route is the current active route of the application. So here we'll just quickly implement the onInit method. So here in the receive component, we'll create a constructor which will inject an instance of activated route and the router. That is, we'll get the current active route of the application. That is, in this case, it will be receive URL. So we'll quickly implement the ng onInit method. So in this method, we'll just write this dot root dot param map. That is, we are using the activated root instance, that is root dot param map. So param map is for mapping the URL of the activated root, that is the current URL. So inside this, we'll just write param that is, we are mapping the parameters of the current URL, and we'll also declare a variable named as selected ID. This is for fetching the value of the parameter from the URL. And here inside this, we'll simply write this dot selected ID is equal to params dot get ID, and ID is the name of the parameter, and here we are going to get the value of the ID parameter. So as you can see, the plus symbol here is just to convert the ID parameter value to number. So this is just for typecasting. So in the template of the receive component, we'll just print the fetch ID. That is, the fetch ID is selected ID. And finally, we'll just give a link, that is router link is send, which is for navigating back to the send page. So as you can see here, we are just using the instance of the activated route here, and we are using the param map method for mapping the parameters of the current URL, and we are just fetching the current URL's ID parameter using the get method, and we are just assigning it to our selected ID variable, and we are just printing it here in our template. So let's run this. Okay, so when I click on the link, you can see here that in the receive component, it is printed as the fetch ID is 1. That is, it is fetching the value of the ID parameter here. Similarly, when I click on back to send page, it will take me back to the send page. Similarly, when I click on the button in the send page, it will again take me to the receive component with a different value of the ID parameter. So in this way, we can fetch the value of the parameters from the URL using the activated route and the param map function. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Kindly subscribe, like, or share.